Hi, we'll be covering the SLCM Securities Law or SEBI sums and practical sums. In your exam, around 15 to 20 marks of sums come. What I have done is I have compiled all the possible exam questions that have come and that can possibly come in your exam and brought it down under one head. So in this, whatever sums I'm doing is the ones which will possibly come in your exam. So take a printout of these notes and solve these notes. I can guarantee you around 15 to 20 marks will be very easily achievable if these type of sums land up in your paper. The first type of sums that we'll be doing is your related to mutual funds. The sums and whichever sums which I'm going to do now, all of this is to be done after you've studied that particular chapter. So only then you will be able to solve the practical parts because I'm not going to explain the concept. Now, the very first part to know is something called as NAV. Now, what is a NAV? Net asset value. Here we'll be computing in the sums, in exams they can ask you, compute the NAV of a mutual fund. Or they can ask you at what NAV will the price be taken. So first, let's understand what is a NAV. Like we invest in companies, right? So we invest in a company. Let's say, for example, I invest in Reliance. So the share price, whatever market price is going on, I would buy at that. So that is called as a share price. Yes or no? Same way for mutual funds. You don't have something called as a share price. You have called as NAV, net asset value, which is showing the value of one unit. Same way as this shows the value of one share, this shows the value of one unit. In a company, there are shareholders. There are shareholders. Whereas in a mutual fund, there are unit holders. Unit holders. So for example, if today I want to buy Aditya Birla Mutual Fund. So I will go and check what is the NAV today. And at that NAV, I can buy my mutual fund unit. Clear till here? So NAV is actually the market value of the security. One security is for how much is the NAV. Now in a company, the share price is continuously till 3:30. We see the market price moving out. Yes or no? Share price going up, share price going down continuously throughout the day. The price, share price is declared. Yes or no? Yes. But for NAV, it is not declared throughout the day. It is declared at end of the day. At end of day, the NAV will be declared. So at any given point of time, you will not come to know the NAV. It will only come to know after the market closes for a mutual fund. Has this difference been clear? So unlike stocks, where the prices are driven by market changes and continuously changes from minute to minute, second to second, mutual funds don't declare their NAV throughout the day. Instead, NAV of all mutual fund schemes are declared at the end of the trading day after the markets are closed. Is this clear?
Yes.
Yeah. Now there are two types of sums that come in. One, they will tell you find out the NAV of the sum. So let's see how the NAV is calculated. Very, very simple. Net asset value. It is the net assets divided by total number of outstanding units. Okay. So, let me explain. Here you will see the net asset of a value. Now, how do you calculate this net asset? Net assets kaise milenge? So, can I say it will be the total assets? Total assets of the mutual fund, wherever they must have invested. If a mutual fund takes money and then further invest in various companies, yes or no? So we have seen so many top class mutual funds prefer to invest in TCS, prefers to invest in Infosys. So the total assets will be the market value of all those investments, yes or no? Yes. So simple सी बात है, अगर म्यूचुअल फंड ने 15 करोड़ इन्फोसिस में डाला है तो 15 करोड़ के एसेट्स है, जैसे तुम इन्वेस्ट करोगे तो तुम्हारे पास एसेट्स होंगे. सेम में म्यूचुअल फंड वेर एवर दे इन्वेस्टेड आर देयर एसेट्स. सो इफ दे हैव अदर काइंड ऑफ रिसीवेबल्स, एनी काइंड ऑफ इनकम और एनी काइंड ऑफ एसेट्स, ऑल ऑफ दैट विल कलेक्टिवली गिव माई टोटल एसेट्स, यस और नो? So, yeah, so the market value of investments keeps changing. So, can I say the total value of total assets also keep changing? Because if mutual fund has invested in Tata Motors and the Tata Motors share price has shot up, so the mutual fund NAV will also go up. So, once you take the total assets, then do you think the mutual fund has only assets or they must be having liabilities also? Expenses also. So when I deduct the total expenses or total liabilities, whatever is the net figure is my net assets, yes or no? So I will subtract the expenses, payables, other liabilities. So all of that will be subtracted. After doing that, let's say they had investments of 30 crores, out of which they had outstanding expenses of 3 crores. So, what is the net asset of the mutual fund? 27 crores. Now, we are going to see that this 27 crores is available as net assets to all the unit holders. Sabko milega 27 crores. कलेक्टिवली तो हमको देखना है इंडिविजुअली पर पर्सन हाउ मच डू दे गेट. सो लेट्स से इफ द सो वी आर सेइंग वी आर गोइंग टू डिवाइड दिस बिकॉज 27 इज फॉर अवेलेबल फॉर एवरीवन. आई वांट टू नो हाउ मच वन पर्सन विल गेट. सो आई विल हैव टू डिवाइड विद द टोटल नंबर ऑफ यूनिट्स. हाउ मेनी यूनिट्स आर देयर? सो दैट वे आई विल कम टू नो वन यूनिट विल टेक हाउ मच. So let's say if I come to know that there are 1 crore units, 1 crore unit holders, each one holding 1 unit. So each one will take home how much? 27 rupees, yes or no? This is your NAV for the day. Clear till here? So what is the NAV? NAV is nothing but the net assets. Net assets, where you take all the assets minus the liabilities and divide by the number of outstanding units. How many units are there? So that way we'll come to know per unit how much is there. Clear till here? This is the simple calculation for NAV. Now we'll see this with the help of a few examples. And one more thing you have to understand with the timing. So this is the NAV calculation. And second is the timing. Timing means what? Let's understand. The cutoff timeline. Now this is important again. So NAV cutoff timeline. Tell me one thing. Is the NAV declared throughout the day or it is declared per day after the market closing?
After the market.
After the market closes, okay? So they have divided it for equity and debt ka, you know, timing has been set as one thing. For the cutoff timelines is for equity and debt funds in a certain fashion and liquid funds in a certain fashion. So let's understand first what it is, then we'll understand it much better. So first we are going to see equity oriented and debt fund. These are the most common and most famous kinds of mutual fund. Equity oriented, I take your money, I invest in equity. Debt oriented, I take your money, the mutual fund will take your money and invest in debt instruments, debentures, fixed income securities, etc. Liquid funds are those funds, those mutual funds which collect your money and they will invest in liquid assets which can be converted into cash any point of time. For example, government securities. So they will invest mostly in the money market, RBI bonds, etc. We don't have to get into that. We just have to understand what are the cutoff timelines. Okay. So let's understand this. Twice exams, in the past year, they have started asking this type of question. So let's see. If I have purchased, so maybe I have purchased of a value of less than 2 lakhs. I have purchased of a value of less than 2 lakhs. Or if I have purchased equity oriented funds or debt funds as a switch in. Now what is a switch in? It is also like a purchase only. So certain mutual funds, they allow switching of the scheme. Switching of the scheme 1 to scheme 2. So if I have gone from scheme 1 and I have switched into scheme 2, can I say I have purchased scheme 2? Yes or no? I have switched into one thing, so obviously I must have purchased that. So it has the same effect. You have entered into one scheme. Either I have purchased it directly or I have come as a switch over into from another scheme. Both effect is I am getting the units of one scheme. Is this clear? I am purchasing. Now if I am purchasing up to 2 lakhs, what is the scheme? Before, so I have done the transaction, let's say before 3 p.m. It is not exactly before, but it is at or before 3 p.m. Means I have purchased at 12 o'clock. I have switched into one scheme or I have purchased one scheme at 12 o'clock. So this scenario will happen. Yes or no? Or if I purchase after 3 p.m. Maybe at any point of the time, I can go at 3:30. I can, 3:15. So after 3 p.m. If I have purchased at or before 3 p.m., the NAV of the same day will apply. Simple. Abhi kiya hai, toh aaj ka hi jo NAV hai, wo lag jayega. But if I, purchase after 3 p.m., then the NAV of the next day will apply for me. Is this clear?
Yes.
So if I have purchased or I have switched into a equity fund or a debt fund before 3 or at 3, the same day NAV will apply और वही NAV पे मुझे पड़ेगा. तो मे भी हो सकता है 15 rupees का NAV है, तो at 15 rupees I will get. But if I purchase it after 3 p.m. then 15 rupees नहीं लगेगा. Today's NAV will not apply. I'll have to see what is the next day NAV. Next day NAV could be 17, so maybe it ended up that I purchased at 17, a little expensive for me. So that way, very simple rules, yes or no. Second, if I am doing, now this was only transactions which were up to 2 lakhs. If I have done a transaction, I have purchased or I have switched into and the value of my buying is greater than 2 lakhs. Let's say I am a big investor, I have invested of worth 10 lakh rupees. I have purchased or I have switched from one scheme to another scheme, I have come in for 5 lakh rupees. So I will come in the second category, yes or no? Now, whenever such a big transaction is done, whether you've done the whether you purchase before or after, NAV of this business day on which the funds are available will be applicable. For example, if I purchase for 5 lakhs, the funds were available on the same day, so that day NAV will apply. But let's say if I have purchased or today, I have given a check and the funds were available after one day. So then whenever the funds were available, because it's some heavy transaction, so whichever day the funds were available to debit and it was debited, that day NAV will apply. So for big transactions, they have bhai jab paisa dega tabhi ka NAV lagao. Generally, when you buy, you have the money, that's when brokers allow, the trading platforms allow you to buy. So that day NAV will only apply. Clear till here? So if I have purchased of 5 lakh rupees and obviously I have the funds in my account, the same day NAV will apply, even if I have done after 3 p.m. Is this clear?
Yes.
Now we were all talking about purchase. Now we are talking of selling or switch out. If I sell, then at what NAV will I get? Or if I get out of this scheme, so then I will obviously redeem. I will get my money when I'm getting out of this scheme. So I want my money back. I give the security. So what NAV will apply at the time of selling? Now that is also very, very simple. And it has to be on the same lines only. So if you go to see, if I do a transaction before 3 p.m., the same day NAV will apply. But if I do after 3 p.m., then the next day NAV will apply. Now this is irrespective of the value of the transaction. So when I'm purchasing, there are two categories, but when I'm selling, there is only one category. Is this clear? So let's see, when we'll be doing the sums. So let's say NAV cutoff timeline. So just taking the cutoff time. So at the time of purchase or switch in, or at the time of redemption, that is sale, or switch out, this has two categories. This, if you done the transaction, here you can say if it is up to 2 lakhs or it is greater than 2 lakhs. Here it's pretty simple. What have they said for sale? If you've done it by 3 p.m., then the same day NAV will apply. But if you do it after 3 p.m., then the next day NAV will apply. Next day NAV will apply. Is this clear? This part sale? Yeah, pretty simple. Now coming to this purchase part. Purchase, again they have divided if it is up to 2 lakhs. And so let's take the first category. If I've done a transaction, a small value transaction, so then they will say like this same rule will apply, this X rule will apply. What is this X rule? That if you've done it by 3 p.m., then the same day NAV will apply. Same day NAV. Okay. Or if I've done after 3 p.m., after 3 p.m., then what will happen? The next day NAV will apply. But if I've done a big transaction, high value transaction, then they will say that the NAV of the day when funds available. So normally kya hota hoga, funds available hai to hi buy karne dega broker ka platform. So that means the same day NAV will only apply, even if I have done it after 3 p.m. So if I have done before or after, generally the same day NAV will apply because you will have the funds in your account. Is this also clear? For liquid funds are those funds which are kept for overnight or for a shorter duration. So companies which they have to make payment for 3 days. So they bring it in the account. Now 3 days also they are losing interest, so they put in these overnight funds where they can easily redeem it for a day, 2 days, 3 days, etc. So here, if you are purchasing or entering into, switching into a liquid fund before 2 p.m., okay, before 2 p.m. and the funds are also available before 2 p.m., then the historical NAV will apply. Now historical NAV is the previous day NAV will apply, so we'll call it as T minus 1. So the trading day, so let's say if you bought it before 2 p.m. today at 12 o'clock, at 11 o'clock, so the yesterday's NAV will apply. If you have done a transaction and you purchase after 2 p.m. or the funds are available after 2 p.m., then the same day NAV will apply. So the same day NAV will apply. Okay, so you can just make the correction. So before 2 p.m. if you've done the transaction and the funds are also available, then the yesterday's NAV will apply. If you've done the transaction after 2 p.m. or the funds are available after 2 p.m., then today's NAV will apply. So either before 2 p.m. historical yesterday's NAV, or after 2 p.m. today's NAV. So you just want to read the text of it. It is given here. That the cutoff time for liquid fund is 2 p.m. If you invest before 2 p.m. in a liquid fund, you will be allotted the units at the NAV of the previous day. This will happen only if you transfer the funds also before the time. If you miss the cutoff time or you submit the funds after 2 p.m., you will be allotted NAV not of yesterday but of today itself. Clear till here? So you need to make this correction. It's not given that well. Then coming to redemption. So if I have sold the mutual fund, liquid funds, or I have switched out of a mutual fund, then if I have done the transaction by 3 p.m., then the NAV of the day of yesterday's NAV will apply. But if I have done it after 3 p.m., then the NAV of the same day will apply. So here, if I have sold before 3 p.m., if I have sold it before 3 p.m., then the same day NAV will apply. Same day NAV will apply. So how are they written? Just pay attention. NAV of the day immediately preceding the next business day. So next business day preceding that day means today only. So the same day, today's NAV will apply if I have done it before 3 p.m. But if I have done it after 3 p.m., so if I have sold it after 3 p.m., then tomorrow's NAV will apply. Next day's NAV will apply. So how are they putting it? In a very, so the next day NAV will apply. So this is a simple thing you can remember. How have they given, let's see, NAV of the day preceding the second business day from submission. So I submitted after 3 p.m. today. So 2 days after ka ek din pehle, that is obviously tomorrow. So they just put it up in a little confusing manner. So for liquid funds, if I have to make the chart, okay, for liquid funds. Now liquid funds are not important from exam point of view. Okay, they haven't come that much. Now liquid funds, if I'm purchasing or if I'm selling, okay, sale or switch out. Now if I have purchased, the cutoff time they are saying is 2 p.m. So if I have done it by 2 p.m. So they say before means at or before. And here if I have done it after. So if I have purchased a liquid fund before 2 p.m. okay, or by 2 p.m. then yesterday's NAV will apply. So the historical NAV or the trading day minus 1 day. Yesterday's NAV will apply. But if I have done it after 2 p.m. then the same day NAV will apply. If I have sold, okay, then again the cutoff time they are going to see is 3 p.m. And I have to see if I have done, I have sold it before 3 p.m. or I have sold it after 3 p.m. So this is again by 3 p.m. So even before or at 3 p.m. also this will apply. If I have done it before 3 p.m. then the same day NAV will apply, and if I have sold it after 3 p.m. then the next day's NAV will apply. Is this clear? So very very simple. Only in the module they haven't given that well. Now coming to the actual sums, let's see. Now R is holding 2000 units of a equity oriented scheme and 1000 units of a debt scheme. So debt and equity ka ek hi tha pehle, liquid funds ka alag hota hai. On 7th June 2020 he was interested to redeem, sell the units. Prevailing NAV of these units are as under. So NAV of 6th, 7th, 8th is given. Now he has done a redemption. He has done a redemption on the 7th. Okay. So he makes a application for selling, that is sale, on the 7th at 2:30 p.m. Based on the information given below, what do you mean by the cutoff time? what is the cutoff time for equity and debt oriented fund except liquid fund. So this is a direct question that they have asked you, the sum. And now they have asked you the sum, what is the applicable NAV in this case? So he has purchased before the cutoff time. What is the cutoff time we have seen? What is the cutoff time? 3 p.m. So therefore the same day NAV will, and the transaction that he has done, we'll have to see the value of the transaction. If it is 2 lakhs or it is greater than 2 lakhs. So he has done a transaction worth how much? So R is holding 2000 shares. Okay. So when it is for redemption, the value doesn't matter. So when he has sold before 3, the same day NAV will apply. So since it is a case of redemption, the same day NAV, that is on 7th, 46 and 34 will apply. Okay, so they have given you the entire table. And here you will have the 46 and 34 will apply. Clear? And I think one more question that they have asked after that. What will be the NAV if the application is made at 315? So if he is made an application for 315, then what will happen? The next day NAV will apply. So in that case, 47 and 33 will apply. Is this clear? In case of equity oriented, 47. In case of debt, 33 will apply. Now we are seeing the other kind of sums, okay, which is calculation of your NAV value, okay, your total assets less your liability divided by the number of shares. Firstly, we had seen NAV, how to calculate all the investments, recoverables, income, less all the liabilities, expenses, etc., divided by the total number of units will give you the NAV. So let's see this sum and try to solve this. Pretty simple. Firstly, name of the scheme XYZ. Size of the scheme 100 lakhs. Face value is given. Your outstanding number of shares is given. Now outstanding shares is going to be used in the formula to divide. We'll have to first find out the total assets. We have to subtract the total liabilities or expenses. And then we will divide by the total number of outstanding units. This will give me the NAV. So let's see, divided by 10 lakhs, market value of the receivable, so 180 lakhs plus your 1 lakh plus your receivables, yes or no, less liabilities and less expenses. So once you do that, so you'll have your 180 lakhs plus 1 lakh plus 1 lakh again plus and then minus 50,000 and minus expenses. Divide by 10 lakhs, you will get your NAV is 18.10 per unit. Simple. Now we are going to see the next question. Let's see how much can we do now. Now maybe the grade of the the sums will increase. ABC mutual fund has the following assets. So they have invested, ABC mutual fund has invested in A, N, D, S, C in this scheme at the close on the 31st March 2021. So this much shares they have of this much market price. The total number of units of the schemes are 10 lakhs. So we know that this is the total unit, so we'll divide by 10 lakhs. The scheme has a accrued expenses, so this will be subtracted, and liabilities, this will also be subtracted. Now we want to know the total assets. Total assets less your total liabilities divided by the number of units. Yes or no? Will give me the NAV. Now this is the number of shares and this is the market price. So if I multiply, I will come to know the market value of each. Yes or no? I will come to the market value of N Limited. So 25,000 ka ek share hai, 20 hai. So unke paas mein kitna hoga? I'll multiply, 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 and then add up all of this to come to know the total investment in the companies that they have made. Mutual fund, once I add it, then I will subtract with 2,50,000 and subtract with 2,00,000. That will give me my NAV. Is this clear? So multiplying all of this, I will get this figure. Then whatever I have added, I will subtract with the liabilities. I'll get my net assets divided by the total number of units. I will come to know my Is this clear? Obviously the calculations you can verify it later on, but you should understand how the sum is actually done. Clear till here? Now we are talking about fund loads. So basically, when you buy, let's say you're going to buy a mutual fund, so there is a buying commission that you have to pay, buying commission, and when you sell, selling again, you have to get a selling commission. So on buy also there is a buying commission, on selling also there is a selling commission. Tell me one thing, can you directly buy or you have to buy through brokers? Can you buy directly or you have to buy through brokers?
No.
So obviously whenever you buy from brokers, they will charge commission. Okay, this is called as your buying commission. So this is called as your front end load. Front end load is nothing but a buying commission. So whenever you buy purchase, that time you have to pay. So for example, if I have it's of 100, okay, then I will have to pay 10 rupees front end load of 10 rupees, and in total I will get it for 110, just like a commission. Now selling, now when I sell also, we have the selling, a sale commission can be taken, that we've sold it for you, let me take a few commission on it. So that is called as a back end load. Now that is called as a back end load, a commission charge at the time of sale. So let's say if I have sold, so this is the first example. Now second, this is the total cost. Now if I've sold worth 100, in my account, you think they will debit, they will credit 100 rupees, or they will subtract their commission, called as a back end load of let's say rupees 10. So in my account only 90 rupees will be hit. Is this clear? Front end load and back end load. So at the time of buying, certain commission is charged. At the time of selling, certain commission is charged. Now, buying commission in India has now been stopped, and SEBI has told you don't take buying commission. So no mutual fund charges buying commission. At the time of buying, agar main 100 rupees ka buy kar raha hu, to 100 rupees ka mil jayega mujhe. Mujhe kuch buying pe commission nahi dena hai. Selling pe, sale pe wo log commission dete hain. Clear yahan tak? So at the time of buying also they can take some. So the concept is you can even at the time of buying charge commission, at the time of selling you can charge, or you can charge them at both the time. In India, only selling commission is allowed to be taken. Buying commission is not allowed to be taken. But for the sums, we will be calculating the front end load and the back end load as well. Is this clear? A front end load is a commission or a charge that you pay when you invest. And this back end load is where you pay when you sell. Now they have given you a formula for front end load and back end load. For front end load and back end load. Let's see. So it is your public offer price is equal to your NAV divided by 1 minus front end load. Clear till here? So if I just further take it, I'm just trying to understand the derivation or what are they trying to really do. First, for you, you don't have to understand the derivation. You just have to understand that this is a formula you need to apply from your exam point of view for the front end load. For the back end load, you have your redemption price NAV divided by 1 plus back end load. I'll just try to explain what this formula exactly is. Okay. Firstly, this is the public offer price 1 minus front end load is equal to your NAV. If I've taken it there, it would be, this would be the case. Yes or no? Now, front end load is actually a percentage. It is a percentage, 5%, 2%, 1%. Now, this percentage is given as of public offer price. So, you have, if you open it, you will have this public offer price, this into this, minus iska, let's say 100 rupees hai, and the front end load is 5%. So here you will have 100, and then this 100 minus 5%. So you'll have minus 5 rupees is equal to your NAV. So NAV will be 95. Now what did this signify? Exactly? Tell me one thing, कि जब NAV कितना है, हम लोग ने calculate किया, how much is the NAV?
95.
But actually when we go to purchase it, front end load लग के कितना offer में होगा? 95, but can I give the 95 rupees and get that amount, or I have to pay something more also, I have to pay the front end load also. So for them, the 100 rupees also has to be paid. That 5 rupees commission has also have to be paid, and the any buyer will have to pay 100 rupees to get this. This 100 rupees includes the front end load. Have you understood this? Yes or no?
Yes.
Or if I take this, if you just want to understand a little more, if I have to take this 5 rupees there, okay, this 5 rupees there, so it would be something like this. So the public offer price is equal to, that is 100 is equal to NAV plus this 5 rupees, which is your front end load. Yes or no? Yes or no? Common sense hai, agar koi bhi cheez 95 ki hai, if it is for 95, you won't get it for 95. You have to pay the commission amount also. That commission is 5. So therefore, collectively, the public offer price is 100 rupees. Is this clear? Yeah. Now this is very simple because this was given directly in rupee terms. Since in your exam they don't give you as front end load as rupees, because it will be very simple, you just add it into the NAV and say that this is the public offer price. They have given you as a percentage of public offer price, and that is why this formula is there. So in the front end load, they give you as a percentage of public offer price, and that is why you have this entire formula. Now if I have to just understand, tell me whether you've understood the formula. Public offer price is equal to, what is the formula? NAV divide by 1
minus
front end load. Now this अभी जो दिया है ना, दिस इज एज अ परसेंटेज, इट इज अ परसेंटेज ऑफ पब्लिक ऑफर प्राइस. ठीक है, हमेशा परसेंटेज ऑफ पब्लिक ऑफर प्राइस दिया. सो इफ आई हैव टू जस्ट डिराइव और मे बी यू नो फर्दर, आई विल टेक द पब्लिक ऑफर प्राइस, ये डिवीजन में है तो उधर जाके 1 माइनस पब्लिक फ्रंट एंड लोड होगा इज इक्वल टू एनएवी. When I will further open it, I'll get public offer price minus, now this is percentage of this. So if this is 5% of 100, so you'll come to know front end load in rupee terms. Yes or no? In rupee terms. is equal to NAV. Now I'll take this public offer price is equal, can also be said as NAV plus front end load. This is in rupee terms. This is your final if you have to see. So agar ye formula hai, to usko further derive karte hain, so you understand that you will come out to this. This makes perfect logical sense. This makes perfect logical sense that NAV plus the commission will give me the actual price that is sold to the person who wants to buy. Is this clear?
Yes.
Yeah. So you just have to remember this is a percentage, and once I'm doing this, this is a final figure. Ek ye ho gaya. Abhi, I hope you all have understood. So you all should be able to derive the next one, that is your back-end load. Now back-end load samajhte hum log, it's a redemption price divided by this. Let's say redemption price, that is on redemption how much money will I have get? What formula they have given? NAV divided by 1. What have they given? 1 plus back end load. Now again, this back end load they have given you as a percentage of redemption price. They have given you as a percentage of redemption price. So if I further simplify this, okay, you will have, I'll take it there, redemption price is equal to 1 plus back end load. Okay, this is a percentage. Is equal to NAV. If I further open it, redemption price plus, abhi agar socho redemption price 100 hai aur ye 5% hai, so then I will do multiplying this redemption price into 5%, you will get 5 rupees. I will come to know the back end load. This is in rupee terms will be equal to NAV. Yes or no?
Yes.
Further, if I say, take it, your redemption price is equal to NAV minus back end load in rupee terms. Where further take this, tell me whether this makes logical sense that NAV jo bhi hoga, usme se buying commission minus karke aapko redeem hoga account mein utna hit hoga. NAV was 100, commission was 5 rupees. 95 will be redeemed and given to you in your account. That is what we are finding. Clear till here?
Yes.
Once you've understood these two formulas and just understand that it just looks complicated, but ultimately you just do, you know, understand it. It's pretty simple. Now we're going to take few examples for this. Okay. Always remember this when they have given you in the formula. It is as a percentage or as in rupee terms.
Okay.
It is given as percentage. So if I tell you it is 10%, so you will write 0.10. If I tell you it is 5%, you will write 0.05. That's 5%, right? So in the question, they are telling you the price, that is the NAV of TSS scheme of mutual fund is rupees 10. Okay. NAV 10. Public offer price is rupees 10.204. And redemption price is rupees 9.80. Calculate front end load and back end load. So I will first write my formula and then I will do it. Then I will see what I need to do. Public front end load formula. Public offer price is equal to NAV 1 minus front end load. Till here it is clear. I will write my formula, then only I will substitute values. Once I have written the formula, then I will say what is the public offer price. So then I will say public offer price is 10.204. So lik diya ye 10.204. Then I will say NAV. NAV kitna diya hua hai? NAV is 10. So I will write the NAV 10. Then I will say 1 minus front end load. They are asking us to calculate the front end load. So 1 minus front end load. So then I will take it there. I'll have 10.204 and 10 point this into front end load is equal to 10. Now both number values, I will bring it on one side. So I will bring 10 on that side and this on that side. So I'll have, you know, or I can take the other way around also. So minus 10.204 front end load is equal to negative this amount, and further you'll do it, you'll get this simple little calculation. Clear till here? So this calculation you can do, it is very simple, nothing complicated. All the number values you have to get on one side, and this front end load you have to keep on one side, and then you'll have to keep the front end load is your divided by this figure. You will come to know it is this much, 0.02, which is actually 2%. Am I clear till here? Yeah. So once you do this, it's going to be pretty simple, nothing complicated. Again, the other one, redemption price, they have to also first I'll write the formula, then substitute the values. So redemption price was given 1 plus back end load. I'll take it there. I'll get 9. So 9.80 plus 9.80 VL back end load. I'll keep it here. I'll take this there. I'll come to know 0.02, then I'll take this into division and I'll come to know it is 2.04%. Clear? So this is how the sums are there. Now coming to the other type of sums which are further going to test your knowledge, and now this is an exam sum which I can say is the most advanced level because it is covering everything. I expect you all to solve it. Let's see. The information relating to one equity oriented mutual fund is given below. So this is as on 2nd Jan and this is as on 3rd January. Now what are they asking? We'll see. First, find out, you are required to calculate the NAV on 2nd and 3rd. So they are asking us to calculate the NAV on this day also, as on this day also. So I will remember what is my formula for NAV. Add up everything, market value, receivables, accrued expenses, add accrued income, accrued expenses, payables minus. And then in the end, I will divide it by the units of mutual funds. Yes or no? Very, very simple. Now they are further asking you, okay, let's see. So this NAV part I believe is very, very simple and nothing complicated in it. You can find the NAV per unit. Now further, the second part they are asking you, let's see. I want you to think and remember. Ramesh invested 1,95,000. Now Q amount diya hai? Because 2 lakhs ke liye alag alag hai na, purchase karte hain, jab buy karte hain tab alag tarike se treatment hai uska. So he is bought up to 2 lakhs and he is bought it at 2 pm. So which day NAV will apply?
Same day.
So calculate the number of mutual fund unit allotted to him. So we will have to say that he has invested this much amount. That day NAV kitna tha, that is on same day. So same day means 2nd Jan ko NAV kitna tha. I will, this amount 1,95,000 is the amount he has invested, divided by the NAV of the 2nd Jan, because same day NAV will apply. Once I divide this, I will come to know the total number of units that he has. So I'll take this, I'll divide it by 39 and I will get 5000 units will be allotted. Why 5000? Obviously, agar A kitne ka hai, so 1 is for 39 rupees. 1 unit is for 39 rupees. So 1,95,000 rupees, how many units you will get? Yes or no? So you will take 1,95,000 divided by 39, you will come to know 5,000 units. So even you want to check 5000 units into 39, you will get the same figure. Clear till here? Yeah. Now this is another kind of mutual fund question that they have asked. Now this they have asked based on common sense. This they have asked on common sense as well. So let's be excited to solve this. A mutual fund has shown a NAV of rupees 11.60 at the commencement of the year. Okay. At the end of the year, the NAV increased to 12.50. Should the investor be happy? Should the investors be happy? NAV was 11.60 at the commencement of the year, and at the end of the year it has increased to 12.50. Should they be happy? Start NAV was 11.60 and end NAV was 12.50. So obviously it has increased. Can you tell me how much amount it has increased? How much is the capital gains to the investor?
Zero point nine.
So it is your 12.50 minus your 11.60 is actually 0.9. Okay, so this is the gain. So they are very happy. Further, meanwhile, the fund distributes 0.75 as dividend and 0.85 as capital gains. So they have distributed further. Okay. Meanwhile, the mutual fund distributes 0.75 as dividend and 0.85 as capital gains. Should the investors be more happy? Yes or no? Obviously, the investors will say we got capital appreciation of 0.9 plus mutual fund has given me a dividend of 0.0 and further they have distributed more of 0.85 as capital gains. Should the investors be extremely happy with this mutual fund? Yes or no? Let's say this is capital gains 1, this is capital gains 2. Double maza. So obviously this is a very good mutual fund. Now let's calculate the return, fund's return. Now if I have to see the return, so it's very simple. It is your return upon investment. If I have to calculate return on investment, ROI, have you heard of it? Word. Any time, any person is there, they always calculate the return on investment. Itna dalunga to kitna milega. So the formula is very simple. Return upon investment. Yes or no? So this is the total returns that an investor gets divided by what is the investment amount. Can anyone tell me what is the investment amount? At what rate did he buy?
11.60.
Very, very good. This was a buy price, right? Usne yehi price pe buy kiya hai. So he got capital appreciation, dividend and capital gains as well. So 11.60 is the investment per unit. This is the return per unit. So then I will divide. I'll come to know. I add up all of this increase in price, dividend, capital gains too. Then holding period return. If I add up all of this, divide by 11.60 is 21.55%. Clear till here? So any point of time where anybody tells you, find out the rate of return on investment. So it will be return upon investment. Clear till your initial investment. The answer will be in percentage. Next, they still have a further follow-up question. Had these distributions be reinvested at an average of 12.20, what is the return for 400 units? Now, what kind of a question is this? Had these distributions, so how much distributions? They're talking about these distributions, these two distributions, the funds distributes. So they are saying this distribution was not done, if this or this distribution was reinvested. Matlab ye dono ko agar reinvest karte to kitna milta? At an average of, so the investment amount is 12.20. What is the return for 400 units? So let's see. What are they trying to say? That the investment amount, investment is 12.20 now, and the return that they will get is this. This is the return per unit. Yes or no? If these ये जो पैसा आया दो dividend और capital gains, इसको मैंने वापस लगा दिया mutual fund में, okay? और obviously वो time पे price वो लोग बोल रहे 12.20 है. 12.20. So then I will say that boss, he has bought how many? 1.60 is the return, and he has bought it at 12.20 into 100. If I do, you understood till here? So I'll come to know how much percentage gain he will get on this also. Now, what question have they asked you? Let's see. What is the return for 400 units? So here they are saying that total return he would have received is 400 units would be 640. So here they are saying, they are asking you a different question, that 1.60 he is going to get in hand, yes or no, per unit. So therefore, for 400 units, okay, he is getting rupees this per unit. So 400 units he will get 640 rupees. Yes or no?
Yes.
Yeah. So this 640 rupees he has got in hand, and he is investing at the rate of 12.20. So we will say 640 divided by 12.20, we will come to know that he will get 52.46 units. Another way to look at it is, one is for 12.20. One unit is for 12.20 rupees. Therefore, for 640 rupees, how many units I will get? So I'll do a cross multiply. 640 divided by 12.20. So I'll come to, so they are asking, he will be able to purchase 12.46 units additionally with that return, what he has done, and he has bought 400 units. Clear till here?